frontal cortex is arguably the most human part of the brain. Proportionately, we've got more complex frontal cortices than any other species out there. It's the most recently evolved part of the brain. Frontal cortex, a big time frontal cortex, is virtually a primate invention. We're humans really running with it. What does the frontal cortex do? All sorts of complicated things, regulating executive behaviors and strategizing. On the very simplest level, what does the frontal cortex do? It makes you do the harder thing when it's the right thing to do. It makes you do something that's difficult when that's what you should be doing. The frontal cortex, okay, you want some terrible, utterly inapplicable metaphor. Frontal cortex is the nearest thing we've got to a superego, the nearest thing to a part of the brain saying, I wouldn't do that if I were you, you were going to regret it. The frontal cortex has this role manifest in all sorts of domains. For example, the frontal cortex makes you at a party do the right thing even though it's harder. You've just been served the most horrendous meal you can ever imagine, and it's your frontal cortex that kicks in that says, whoa, this is delicious, I've got to have the recipe. The frontal cortex is what gets you to compliment somebody's hideous new hairdo. The frontal cortex keeps you from being a serial murderer. It keeps you constrained. It keeps you in line. The frontal cortex is also something that kicks in a very dramatic way during early development. Most of us way back when had to suddenly get a lot of frontal function when we learned to be toilet trained. And that is something that soon moved from frontal executive control to implicit pathways. Most of us don't have to think consciously anymore about being toilet trained, but early on, that was one of the big initial frontal tasks that we had to master. Okay, so frontal cortex. Frontal cortex, all sorts of fascinating other features of it. And as just became clear, part of development, child development, is your frontal cortex maturing. And you can show the fact that kids don't have a whole lot in the way of a frontal cortex by brain imaging, things of that sort, and you find out something absolutely astonishing. The frontal cortex is the last part of the brain to fully develop. Your frontal cortex is not fully developed until around age 25. That is astonishing. That explains an awful lot of behavior in freshman dorms. That explains all sorts of things. The frontal cortex takes forever to develop, and thus childhood is filled with a frontal cortex that doesn't work very well yet. You can show this wonderful study, this wonderful experimental paradigm, where you take kids, and what you do is you put the child in a room, and you put a marshmallow in front of them, and you say, okay, here's the deal. I'm going out of the room, I'm gonna come back in a while, and if you want, while I'm out of the room, you can have that marshmallow. On the other hand, if you don't eat it, when I come back, you can have two marshmallows. In other words, can you regulate your behavior, regulate this impulsive desire to grab that marshmallow? And kids very early on are awfully, awfully challenged in order to hold on and not grab the marshmallow early on. And in fact, there is a literature by now showing you take like four-year-olds, and the longer they can hold on not taking the marshmallow, the more frontal regulation they have of their behavior. And that is in part predictive of things like SAT scores a decade later in high school. This is the mark of a frontal cortex that is developing in a very impressive manner.